That's too bad you're recording.
I got this magic thing called a pen that connects to my
phone. I got this magic thing called I don't care if somebody catches me singing anymore because it taught me self-confidence.
Good for you.
By demonstration.
Welcome to our second video. The first video was amazing. We talked about singleness and how we dealt with it and how we were okay with it and how we were not okay with it at the same time and how we overcame it by getting married.
Which hasn't happened yet, so you can stop talking about that.
By the way, this is brought to you by Jesus. I mean Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Anywho, point of this next video that we're doing, we're going to talk about our job hunting and how that's going for us. Mostly for her, because she's the one doing most of the job hunting. Since I had a job with Lazy Boy, being a lazy man on the job. Oh my gosh. Long live the lazy, as they say, at Lazy Boy.
Where is that water bottle anyway?
I think I put it away in the cupboard. Pretty sure I did. Anywho. So, Tanya's been job hunting, and she's going to talk about that and how that is going compared to her old job hunting. And then I'll talk about my job hunting and how that's going.
Do you really want to compare and contrast how far I've come?
Sure. Oh,
it's like a bit depressing.
Yeah. Yeah. I believe in you. They believe in you.
It's not even live. Who believes in me?
But the person that's watching in the future, watching the video and going, what a lovely couple. Or they're thinking, wow, what dorks.
Or the trolls that be like, yeah, that marriage will be over in a single day.
Oh yeah, we had to deal with that earlier today.
The comment said, I have milk with a longer shelf life than this marriage. It's like, that's a little uncalled for.
Yeah, it was a little rough to hear. But at the same time, I'm like, I've learned to just tune those people out.
This is also the first time we've been told we're a bad fit for each other, so I'm really...
Not the first time.
Not the first time.
There was a video that I made near the beginning of our relationship, and I literally flipped out as we were heading to either Fred, not from our
so we Safeway. Were leaving Safeway, I believe.
Yeah. No, we're going to Safeway. I don't even remember what it was about. It was this guy that's like, run, Tanya, run. Get out while you still can, or
I'm
something
still
like that.
Confused why trolls think we're not a good fit. So if any trolls are watching this, actually elaborate on what the heck you mean.
And before,
because just telling us we're not a good fit does not answer my question. I want to know why. I'm all about the whys and the hows.
But she said, anywho, if you're going to make a judgment, make sure you watch all of our videos and read all the posts and actually look at our life.
What he said.
So just look at one video and just be like, oh, automatically, not good fit, because look at that dude, he looks like a loser. Oh, look at her, she looks like a hobo. Oh, look at her, she looks like a man. Oh, look at him, he looks like a fag. I probably shouldn't use that word. This is
That's why.
Why
I said heck just now, but yeah, I just ignore all that, apparently.
Right? who cares about that?
Pardon my French, but he's so heckin' cute!
Oh, yeah, well, you're beautiful.
Okay.
Anywho, how is the work search going?
I have an interview tomorrow.
With who?
Pilot.
Who are they?
Pilot, as far as I understand, is basically a gas station, not supply store, but like where you get your goods and stuff. They have a McDonald's branched off of it and snacks and drinks and fill up your car tank stuff. Basically just what's a good word for this? Glorified Quickie Mart. So it's much larger than like your standard cigarettes and juice stop. It has a whole McDonald's attached to it. A whole restaurant McDonald's right there.
It's a truck stop depot, basically.
That too. Flat trucks as well.
So it has like a mini store for people who are traveling and they need stuff like toiletries or food or electronics, you know. It makes it a lot easier than having to go off a road and go back a couple other roads to go to some other roads to try to get some other roads.
Quickie Marts are nice, what you're trying to say. But the job I applied for was deli production team member, I think. But it's what it sounds like. It's going to sound like it's going to be very similar to what I worked with at Trader Joe's when we assembled salads on an actual assembly line that was on a conveyor belt. So the machine would drop the salad trays. And each person has a designated role. So we have the lettuce dropper. It has to be dropped. You have each person for each topping, and someone put dressing on, and then the very last person would close it, Sorry, second to last person closed the lids and what? Okay, the second to last person will be responsible for closing the lids and cleaning up the edges of the container. And the very last person in line will be responsible for putting the labels on. If anything like that, I'll be just fine. I'll hate it the whole time, but as long as everybody keeps their trap shut, looking at you. I think his name was Chris. Ironically, this Christmas Chris was also black. But not at all. SSC Chris. Not even close to the same person. This guy's a felon. This guy, he kind of ruined my day a lot.
I'm sorry.
Hopefully I've changed enough since then to not let that get to me anymore, but I guess we'll find out.
So.
Also, don't work for Trader Joe's. They hire felons.
They do.
Oh, the warehouse. You're desperate enough. The warehouse. I mean, let me specify. The warehouse side hires felons. I don't know if the stores do. I've never worked in retail, so I don't know anything about the store side.
So, I also applied there with her with a different position. I believe the deli position, from what I'm understanding and seeing, it's basically she'll be working for Subway. From what I'm seeing, understanding and seeing.
They didn't say sandwich artist. I don't know. I guess it could be anything, really.
Good luck. Good luck making sandwiches. I might have to come walk all the way to your work from our home, which I know I can do easily.
Since it's a full-time position, so I'm looking forward to that, too. I'm beyond the point where I need part-time positions, so.
And while she's been mostly job hunting, but today I decided, you know, out of love, despite the fact that I'm probably going to be staying home anyway as a full-time student at home, which I haven't been a full-time student most of this time because I've been busy with other things called life. We went job hunting, and that was a fun experience. We went and walked.
No, you went job hunting. I just tagged along.
Yeah, that was nice. I haven't had that happen in a long time. I think it's been like 7 years, give or take, since the last person.
Hey, Victor. One day. We'll have been together for 7 years.
Yep, that will be a thing.
How does that feel for you?
Very foreign and very long ways away. But if anything I've learned so far is time goes by really fast. I applied to Sherry's and Denny's and an Irish pub and a pizza place, an Italian place, a sub.
So
place.
Many memorable names. You can just name them all so easily and quickly.
We were walking around, so it was
random. That one pizza place, that one, what else did you say? Italian place, that's fine.
They're all within a 10-minute walk, basically, of our apartment.
Yeah, there's a lot of restaurants around here. That is definitely accurate.
It's very nice. Mostly dishwashing positions is what I applied for because I'm looking for a part-time position, just something to keep me busy. If it so happens they have a full-time position, they'll keep me busy. I would be hesitant to take it, depending on what's going on. Tony and I have been doing AWG, but as I had a strong feeling it wouldn't pan out, work well for both of us with AWG, just because of the fact that, like...
You have to be really, basically really desperate, I found out. I tried. There's this one job in the Shayla's that opened up, but then someone else snatched it up, so it doesn't matter.
And then there was the Fife. We didn't even try that.
They wanted an hour out of our way.
Yeah, mostly. And they wanted a 4 p.m. to midnight, and I'm just like, nope, I can't do that. I know I'm busy most nights as it is.
We so, have standards.
We have to be a little picky. Right now, we have that freedom. We can be a little picky. You know, we got enough money in the bank to get by comfortably for about 3 to 4 months if we're...
No, why were you getting on my case about declining another job offer that had excessive overtime?
So something that I have learned is being proactive. So when you're being proactive about something before you have a need, it makes it so that you can transition much smoother and it prevents you from losing all your money. We're about to get married in less than 30, almost 32 days. No, it is 32 days today. Tomorrow will be 31 days until we get married.
32 is a power of 2.
Yeah, which means...
Wait,
we're gonna be. There's gonna be one household, and we live in a really nice apartment. Really nice, $2,000 a month. That's not cheap. Now the way we've
everybody seems to be balking at it. Mortgages are cheaper than this place.
Yeah. So like.
That's an awkward conversation to have.
And like we're trying to plan for the future. Our goal is to move 5 to 6 years or less to Canada. And in order to do that, you have
6 years. You add a year every time you bring it up.
It's three years.
Michael's was actually two, but two. Yeah. So to ignore that.
Well, I'm trying to be realistic.
Number. So am I. Yeah. I wanted to leave this country by the end of this year. Obviously, that didn't happen.
No, she's getting married instead. Maybe next year. No. That required Will Lewis the whole job for a whole year.
Good luck.
I'm talking about me more than her. There's a reason why she's the breadwinner, and I'm going to be the pastor. The guy that spends his life in spiritual stuff. And
I will work at a job until I get fired for whatever reason they come up with.
I usually do that.
I have that such personality where it's very difficult to fire me because I don't have workplace violence issues. I don't really get in fights with my coworkers that much. Sometimes I'm just bad at my job. So it's very hard for the employers to be like, we gotta get rid of her somehow. But she's so nice or everything else. She just doesn't do her job well. So I end up having these jobs for like a couple of years before they finally figure out what to do with me. So I lasted in the Army for 2.5 years because of that. I just had cooperation issues. Let's put it like that. But I wasn't violent. I wasn't like irrevocably broken, just disobeying everything. I'm like a cat. I obey you when I feel like it. I wasn't. I was in my early 20s, late teens.
That's a mood. Well, with that being said, thank you for talking with me a little bit about the job search and how that's going. I'm definitely hopeful for you getting the job as a pilot. Sad. The reason I was so sad about her not getting the Centralia job.
Chehalis.
I get those two mixed up all the freaking time.
They are neighboring cities.
Extremely neighboring. Like, I can walk between them.
They have, their borders are touching. Touching more than we are right now, for example.
We're touching them. My knee's touching your leg.
Don't count that. Nobody can see that. You can't prove it.
Okay. Anywho. But, like, it was $20 an hour. It was a full-time gig. It was a shift where she would be able to start, I think, 7 in the morning and get off at 3.
It wasn't bad.
It was a good thing, and I was excited. Monday through Friday, like, I would love her to have that schedule. That would give us enough time in the morning through afternoon to work on my studies while she's over at work. And when she comes home, we'll be able to spend the rest of the afternoon and evenings shopping or going on dates or, you know, yelling alive for church and stuff. And she could be part of this house and family. And, like, I was kind of devastated when I heard that. I'm not lying. And then they had another position, but they're like, yeah, overtime. And I'm like, you should go for that one. Tom's like, no, double overtime. Never again. So I was like, okay. That was a thing.
Yeah, no, I spent 2 years at Medline's overtime standards. I'm just like, no, I'm good.
I think Medline's very unique. They are the only company I've ever worked for that's had that type of overtime.
Like what?
That bad of overtime. Like every day overtime.
Yeah, something weird happened at the turn of the year. So around this time last year, we were doing fine. And then the holidays hit, got Thanksgiving and Christmas and New Year's, now that's jazz. And when Medline Medline is a medical supply company, so holidays don't care if you're sick. You're still gonna be sick, even through the holidays. So we had to play catch up every time either the warehouse shut down for the national holiday, or because people were just taking time off because holidays. And, you know, this last year, I feel like they were playing catch up and they just never caught up again. Like, we just had a 4-hour day. We are supposed to work 8-hour shifts, but they are allowed to post anywhere from 30 minutes to 4 hours of overtime. I've never seen the legendary 5 hours plus. I've heard about it, never saw it, thank God. I'll probably just put on the spot. I think they know it. But and it would just be 4 hours plus, so it's 4 hours or less for like the rest of the time I was there for like the next 6 months. And it was insane. I was losing my mind.
I remember she would come home. I would meet her here. She'd be so freaking tired that she barely would be able to have me come over and visit her before I would leave to go to Little Creek Casino at 9. I thought about going back to Little Creek Casino, if I'm going to be honest. I could go back there, I think. From what I understand, I just had to wait 3 months, and it's definitely been 3 months since I left. So if I really wanted to, I could probably return.
I left Medline on good terms. I did the whole 2 weeks notice thing and everything, and I've been asked already multiple times if I'm ever thinking of going back, and every single time someone asks me, it's no. Did you hear me the first time? I said no.
I keep thinking that's a divine interruption, that I'm not the only one that keeps asking that. But if you don't want to do something, don't do it. Don't. I mean, I've been in that position where I've worked jobs where I didn't want to do them because I was that desperate. I was living with my sister, yeah. I got free rent, yeah. It was nice living with her. But she had me take care of everything myself. Getting to work, getting from work, take care of my food, my livelihood, taking care of basically every little thing. And, you know, because of her unwillingness to help me, I often wasn't able to even pay much rent because I was too busy taking care of other things, like my car and food and, you know, gas. And, oh my gosh, I cannot tell you how much money I spent on that Jeep. I miss my Jeep to death. I really do. And if I ever got a chance to get another one, I probably would. Maybe a newer model, to be honest.
And that's your truck or your Jeep more?
Truck. Definitely the truck. I'm still pissed that the person that was selling it to me decided, oh yeah, I want to sell it to my friend instead for full price. And oh yeah, you get nothing. I literally had to talk. We're not going down that. That is a very touchy subject. But basically, in a word, a person went back on the word, selling a Nissan Frontier to me, and I was very unhappy because at the time I started my own landscaping business called Hannah Landscaping. It was not a registered LLC, so it was not official, but I did use it and her equipment that she let me use to go around and make money here and there from people nearby. And I enjoyed doing that very much. I'm very much of the mind that I do a lot better when I have freedom to choose what I do during the day. I don't like structure. I do not like it that I'm forced to Monday to Friday or whatever week today, go to a job, work eight plus hours, get off, go home. I like having that freedom to be able to just, you know, live my life, have room to be able to say, oh yeah, today I'm not going to work today. Today I want to go and take care of something else. I mean, it's ridiculous, the jobs that are going on. Like, I'm going to be honest, I feel like I'm being owned by a company. I don't feel like I have the freedom to just go call work and say, hey, I don't want to come in today, without fear of being thrown out by most companies. It's just how the way it is, and the reality is, which is part of the reason why I'm not as tolerable as some people is with working long term. That's actually part of the biggest reason why
most of us just suck it up, dude.
Yeah, I can't, and I will. Actually, sorry, let me rephrase it. I won't suck it up. I refuse to. I do not like having my life controlled by people I don't even know that I have to work for on a daily basis. Like, that concept is very foreign and hard for me. Like, I don't like it that I have to tell my friends.
It shouldn't be foreign. Oh, yeah. That's how America works.
Yeah, that's why I don't like living in America or anywhere. I'd rather be dead and live in heaven with my Lord and Savior, praising him for all eternity. Well, not kidding. You know what I mean. But anywho,
no. If you say goodbye, I'm not gonna let you.
Goodbye. I said goodbye. So I was playing with the camera for a second there. And she went to grab my hand and put my hand on her face. I said, goodbye! Followed by... Anywho, we're back.
Whatever, man.
Whatever.
Like, I just hijacked the entire conversation there. I had more to say about Medline.
Keep talking about Medline!
Anyway, one thing I definitely learned from that place is that I'm about me, and if the job is not going to cater to my needs, then I don't want it. That's literally all I was going to say. I used to work for 5 minutes on a freaking pickup truck. So there.
I spent 5 minutes talking about the pickup truck. Although we avoided talking for 5 minutes about the pickup truck.
Just talked about it. Yeah. You just forget the whole thing you just said, a giant monologue?
That was like less than 2 minutes?
I don't care. You think I'm timing this?
No.
But I am. Okay, fine. How much time has elapsed so far?
1 minute.
How many seconds after the minute?
15.
Nope.
I was off by 10 seconds.
Yes, you were.
Anywho, I'm really hopeful for Tanya when it comes to work, and I'm also hopeful for myself. I'm looking for a nearby home job just to keep me busy at this point. I'm not, part-time seems to be the best type of position for me. It's more time at home, more time I can study, but I'm still making something better than nothing. I will be myself working for Lethea Digital Media from time to time when they have some work for me, possibly. Anything else you want to add before I end?
Nope. No? I'm good.
You're good? Okay. Well, thank you folks for watching this video with us. I appreciate you guys' time, and I hope you have a really good rest of your day, night, evening, morning, you know, whatever. Anyway, thank you for watching.